In recent weeks, since mid-May, public health authorities have been investigating a global outbreak, identifying cases in countries that monkeypox has typically not been found, including the United States. On May 18th, a case of monkeypox was diagnosed in a U.S. resident in Massachusetts. That was the first case of monkeypox in 2022. Now, investigations are ongoing to understand the spread of monkeypox, although it's believed to be spread through very close contact among social networks, and especially through sexual contact. At this time, we really have focused on a few key measures. One of them is caring for the patient, and so are our healthcare institutions. Secondly, identifying who has been exposed, notifying them, and offering measures to prevent infection, which include vaccination. And thirdly, really focusing on raising awareness about monkeypox in the general public. As we learn more, it's really important for all of you to know what the symptoms are and what to do if you think you might have monkeypox and might have exposed others. People who are infected with monkeypox typically develop symptoms, and that can include fever, swollen lymph nodes, muscle aches, and chills. And then 1 to 3 days later, they can develop a rash. And this can look like a skin rash that's not raised. It can also look like fluid-filled sores or vesicles throughout the body. They can be in the face, they can be in the arms or legs, and they can also be in the genital area. And that varies from person to person. People can get monkeypox through very close contact with someone who's infected with monkeypox or showing symptoms. And that can be in a few ways. First of all, it can be through mouth-to-skin contact and skin with the rashes or sort of vesicles that can appear when someone's sick. It can also be skin-to-skin contact, and that can be through kissing and touching. And then it can also be if you touch the bedding, linens, or clothes of someone who's infected with monkeypox as well. Face-to-face contact can also happen if you're in very close proximity to someone who's infected. And those are the most common ways to get monkeypox. How do you protect yourself from getting infected? A few key things. Importantly, avoid close contact, including mouth-to-skin contact and skin-to-skin contact, with people who are feeling ill or who have a new and unexplained rash. Secondly, if you are a healthcare provider or you're caring for someone with monkeypox, it's important to wear a mask around them. Some people can develop more severe disease. However, this is quite rare, anywhere from 1 to 11% of cases that have been observed. Right now, we're really focused on getting the information out there to the public so that they can recognize symptoms in case they're sick, they can isolate, and then others who might be exposed could get the treatments that are available to prevent infection, which include antiviral treatments and vaccines. So most people who are infected with monkeypox will have symptoms for a few weeks, and then they'll go away on their own. We do not believe that the cases that are currently identified otherwise pose a risk to the general public, because we know that this disease is typically spread through very close contact. For more information on monkeypox, you can turn to several different sources, including the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the World Health Organization, and the Boston Public Health Commission website, social media, and other outlets.